Good evening. Welcome to Ash Wednesday's evening service at 7 p.m. here on Facebook Live. Thank you for joining us this evening. This is the day that starts our Lenten season. It's our start of our journey to the cross as we follow Jesus. And we welcome you into this season, a season that is specific to liturgical churches, and we thank you for being here. It's a time to center our hearts, and it's a time to be purposeful in our thinking and putting Jesus first. Welcome to this evening's service. Let us begin with the prayer of the day. Actually, I do have one announcement that I need to make. I need to start this evening's service with a very sad announcement that our very dear friend, Paul Daly, passed away yesterday morning. Please keep his family in your prayers. He was a rock to this church, and all who knew him loved him. Prayer of the day. Almighty and ever-living God, out of your love and mercy, you breathe into the dust the breath of life. Forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create in us new and honest hearts, so that truly repenting of our sins, we may serve our neighbors with kindness and love. Call forth our prayers and strengthen us to face our mortality with confidence in the mercy of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. He lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Of injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressors go free, and to break every yoke. Is it not to share your bread with the hungry, and bring the homeless poor into your house, when you see the naked, to cover them, and not to hide yourself from your own kin? When your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring up quickly, your vindicators shall go before you, the glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, "Here I am." If you remove the yoke from among you, the pointing of the finger, the speaking of evil, if you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness, and your gloom be like the noonday. The Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your needs in parched places and make your bones strong, and you shall be like a watered garden, like a spring of water whose waters never fail. Your ancient ruins shall be rebuilt. You shall raise up the foundations of many generations. You shall be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of streets to live in. Word of God, word of light.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm for Ash Wednesday is Psalm 51, verses 1 through 17. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love. In your great compassion, blot out my offenses. Wash me through and through from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my offenses, and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. So you are justified when you speak, and right in your judgment. Indeed, I was born steeped in wickedness, a sinner from my mother's womb. Indeed, you delight in truth deep within me, and would have me know wisdom deep within. Remove my sins with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be purer than snow. Let me hear joy and gladness, that the body you have broken may rejoice. Hide my face from my sins, and blot out all my wickedness. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my wickedness. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and sustain me with your bountiful spirit. Let me teach your ways to offenders, and sinners shall be restored to you. Rescue me from bloodshed, O God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. For you take no delight in sacrifice, or I would give it. You are not pleased with burnt offerings. The sacrifice of God is a troubled spirit, a troubled and broken heart, O God, you will not despise.
Our gospel reading tonight comes to you from Matthew chapter 6, 1 through 6, 16 through 21. Beware of practicing your piety before others in order to be seen by them. For then you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogue and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received the reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and in the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received the reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you fast, do not look dismal like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces so as to show others that they are fasting. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face so that your fasting may be seen not by others, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, but where moth and rust consume and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. The Gospel of the Lord. Good evening. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So what a pretty snow week we have had. I hope that it brought calm and peace to your days and not stress or worry. I hope you're able to prepare ahead for it. And it left just in time for Lent. It's ironic, really. The light of the snow melting just as we move into the season of Lent. Sometimes Lent has a feeling of darkness to it, or a thickness, or maybe melancholy is the right word. Or another word might be focused, or purposeful, or thoughtful. And if you're really into Lent, the word might be centered and calm. Now there's an emerging into the season of Lent. It can be a season of deep water faith, or it can be a season where we stand on the side looking at the water. Either way, we have to wade into the depths of the Lenten season until Easter morning breaks through. So I hope this time of Lent is meaningful to you. Today is Ash Wednesday, the start of Lent. Now in this service, we're not going to be doing the ashes for this service, but I invite you to still hear the words because they're important. Today we remember our mortality and we hear the words. Remember, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. Well, it's not always a pleasant exchange of words. There is meaning to them. There are many meanings to them. The basic of these many meanings is to remember that God is God and we are human. And even in our mightiest of days and in all power that we have ever had, we are human and we are made from the dust of the ground, the same Adam as Adam was in the beginning. God is God. And we are human. Ash Wednesday is the start of the Lenten season. It is a reminder to turn from the world for 46 days and journey with Jesus, a journey that ends at the cross. We spend this time to draw closer to Jesus. We dedicate 40 days about to learn about who Jesus is, about his ministry, and about how he is the Son of the living God. We're to spend this time drawing near to God. Often people spend time in Lent either doing something like service or donating money to special charities. Or they spend time in Lent not doing something, like fasting from food or from other things. Some people take this time to strengthen their spiritual journeys, like praying more or committing to reading the Bible more, or attending midweek Lenten services. Now I know we all miss our soup suppers, but there will be midweek Lenten services just as before. And we're gonna be looking at the Bible stories that we don't hear during the regular church cycle, ones that have been left out of the lectionary. So please tune in every Wednesday at 7. And there are also some people who don't do anything for Lent at this time. As the scripture points out, it's not about showing off what you do or what you don't do or what you add in or what you take away. It's about growing closer to Jesus. It's about drawing near to God. Lent is about spending time with God, and without a doubt, it's about slowing down. Now, normally, as a pastor, I have to work extra hard at turning you away from the world. Many people take vacations during this time or are planning travel. People are busy with work and taxes, resetting a calendar for the new year. Overall, our minds are busy on so many other things that pastors have to continually remind you that you need to switch your focus back to Jesus. Now, this year, I anticipate will be a little easier to keep you and myself focused on the season. This year, unlike any other year, we totally get Lent. We get giving things up. We get the feeling of thickness in the air. We have been doing a Lent journey for a year now, and frankly, we're pretty over it. But even though we are not participating in life like we were before, that doesn't mean that we're not distracted. We're just distracted as before, just with different things. But there is a difference this year. And it isn't that we're less distracted, but it's that there is more space. There is more opportunity for rest. There is more quiet than before. The same distractions in some ways, like sports, winter fun, and school, they're still there. But there's a natural slowdown in the world. Just enough space to take a breath from the world for the next 46 days. Some of you do remember when Sundays meant no stores were open and not many cars were on the road on Sundays. You knew that no package or mail would come. There was no such thing as two-day free shipping. There was a slowness that was built into the rhythm of life. Monday through Saturday was busy, but Sunday was different. I barely remember Sundays being like that. Most of my life, the stores have been open, the mall has been open, the restaurants have been open. Basically, anything I could do Monday through Saturday, I could do on Sunday. But going back to the very beginning, things were supposed to be different. Genesis reads, "Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day, God finished the work that he had done, and he rested on the seventh day from all the work that he had done. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it, God rested from all the work he had done in creation." God rested, and we are supposed to rest as well. There's a natural need for rest. That doesn't mean it was easy then or now. And we have learned that too much rest can be as challenging as being too busy. We have forgotten how to rest, and this pandemic has given us pause in the crazy daily life and put in that quiet space that was needed, even if we don't like it that much. And now it is Lent. And there is plenty of quiet and also plenty left to do. It is hard to rest when the world sits outside your window. So maybe this Lent isn't about slowing down, because if we slow down anymore, the snail is going to win the race. Maybe this Lent is more about figuring out how to have balance in our lives, how to have the fun, the work, the school, the travel, and also bring back a rhythm of life that includes rest and stillness and quiet and Sabbath. How do we balance all of life and actually include Jesus in it? That is the question. And not just Jesus as a 1 hour on Sunday kind of deal, but include bringing Jesus into everyday living, into the quiet and the not so quiet spaces. How do we balance and find health and well-being and religion all in our ordinary days? Soon, life will get busy again, and we will rush quickly out into it. Soon, we'll start running around more and more and adding in more and more things. But can we keep some of the rest? Some of the quiet and some of the space? And for this Lenten season, just as before, I ask you, can you purposefully add Jesus in? So here are a couple of ideas. You can add in a table prayer, a Bible study, reading the Bible. Did you know that there are 5 books in the Old Testament and 15 books in the New Testament that will take you less than 10 minutes to get through them? Some will only take 5 minutes. You could read these 20 books every other day during Lent and be 30% done with the reading of the Bible. Now, the rest of the books are considerably larger, but that sure is a good chunk to take off right now. You could spend the time you spend gardening or skiing or listening to music and also spend that time thanking God for what you have or praying about others. Some people see a certain object and pray for a certain person, like every time an airplane flies overhead or every time you hear those noonday bells ring, you pray for someone. I don't know what it is that you can do, but I would love to hear of the things that you do during Lent or don't do. But I think that the whole purpose of Lent is to develop or redevelop your relationship with God. This Lent, it is probably more about finding balance between the busy and the rest. But in balance or out of balance, Lent is a time to draw closer to God. So let us pray. Gracious God, we come to you in the silence. We come to you in a time when there has been too much silence and too much quiet, too much rest. And even with that, we confess that we are busy and distracted. We still move too fast and we still miss seeing you in our daily lives. Oh God, awaken our spirits. Open our eyes and our ears to see you, hear you, and experience you during this Lenten season and throughout our journey of life. Help us follow Jesus to the cross. Help us follow Jesus to the empty tomb. Help us follow Jesus to the resurrection. Thank you for this time which calls us from ourselves and asks us to focus on you. May we put God in our daily lives. In Jesus' holy name, amen. This next part, we are going to take some moments to do these confessions of sin. This is the time of repentance, and these confessions, I feel, are fairly deep, and I hope that you hear that and allow yourself to feel them as we move forward into our Lenten service. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. Most holy and merciful God, we confess to you and to one another and before the whole company of heaven that we have sinned by our own faults and by our own fault, our own most grievous fault, in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart and mind and strength. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not forgiven others as we have been forgiven.
Have mercy on us, O God.
We have shut our ears to your call to serve as Christ served us. We have not been true to the mind of Christ. We have grieved your Holy Spirit.
Have mercy on us, O God.
Our past unfaithfulness, the pride, envy, hypocrisy, and apathy that have infected our lives, we confess to you.
Have mercy on us, O God.
Our self-indulgent appetites and ways, and our exploitation of other people, we confess to you.
Have mercy on us, O God.
Our negligence in prayer and worship, and our failure to share the faith that is in us, we confess to you.
Have mercy on us, O God.
Our neglect of human need and suffering, and our indifference to injustice and cruelty, we confess to you.
Have mercy on us, O God.
Our false judgments, our uncharitable thoughts toward our neighbors, and our prejudice and contempt towards those who differ from us, we confess to you.
Have mercy on us, O God.
Our waste and pollution of your creation, our lack of concern for those who come after us, we confess to you.
Have mercy on us, O God.
Restore us, O God. Let your anger depart from us.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. Merciful God, accompany our journey through these 40 days. Renew us in the gift of baptism that we may provide for those who are poor, pray for those in need, fast from the indulgence, and above all, that we may find our treasure in the life of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the church, the world, and all in need. O God, you call your church to be ministers of reconciliation throughout the world. Inspire your church in its proclamation of the gospel and guide its ministries to build up the body of Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O God, you created the earth and all its inhabitants, and you declared that it is good. Protect mountains and valleys, animals and plants, and direct us to be good stewards of all you have made. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O God, you desire peace. Direct governments and leaders to work for the well-being of all people, and raise up advocates to speak and serve on behalf of the downtrodden. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O God, you are our hope in the midst of despair, our help in the midst of sorrow, and our consolation in the midst of affliction. Grant comfort to all who suffer in body, mind, and spirit, especially those we remember aloud or in our hearts, and support caregivers who attend to all in need. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O God, you are love, and you call us to love one another. Accompany with your grace those journeying towards baptism, and call us all to repentance as we prepare to celebrate Christ's death and resurrection. Lord, in your mercy. God, you are our life and our salvation. We give you thanks for the righteous who have died in faith. We give you thanks for Paul Daly, a man of great faith. Inspire us by their example to proclaim your steadfast love. Lord, in your mercy. We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you. Accompany us in this meal, that we may pass over from death to life, with Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Blessed are you, O God of the universe. Your mercy is everlasting, and your faithfulness endures from age to age. Praise to you for creating the heavens and the earth. Praise to you for saving the earth from the waters of the flood. Praise to you for bringing the Israelites safely through the sea. Praise to you for leading your people through the wilderness, to the land of milk and honey. Praise to you for the words and deeds of Jesus, your anointed one. Praise to you for the death and resurrection of Christ. Praise to you for your spirit poured out on all nations. In the night which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." With this bread and this cup, we remember our Lord's Passover from death to life as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, and Christ will come again. O God of resurrection and new life, pour out your Holy Spirit on us and on these gifts of bread and wine. Bless this feast. Grace our table with your presence. Come, Holy Spirit. Reveal yourself to us in the breaking of the bread. Raise us up as the body of Christ for the world. Breathe new life into us. Send us forth burning with justice, peace, and love. Come, Holy Spirit. With the body of Christ, your holy ones of all times and places, with the earth and all its creatures, with sun and moon and stars, we praise you, O God. Blessed and holy Trinity, now and forever. Amen. Let us speak now the words that Jesus taught. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Whether we give something up at Lent, or whether we don't give something up at Lent, or whether we add something in or don't add anything in, that's not the point. The point is, how do you draw closer to God? Through this meal, this is a time where we do come close to God. Wherever the Lord's table is, it is a time where Jesus comes to you. A time where you come in an honest sort of way and just put it out there for Christ. It's a time of desire for you to desire Jesus and for Jesus to desire you. This meal is for all people and all are welcome at the table. Come. The meal is set and Jesus is waiting. This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. God is steadfast love. At this table, you gather your people into one body. For the sake of the world, send us the power of your Spirit,
that our lives bear witness to the love that has made us new in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thanks be to God.